Hello, you all welcome to my channel once again. Those who are watching me for the first time, I have to introduce myself to you so that you know your teacher. My name is Daniel Amwakun, an ACCA Chartered Accountant. I practice and also provided accounting bookkeeping services, including other services, as well as teaching accounting for more than 20 years. Don't want to waste your time. Let us get straight into the video. Well, those who have watched my previous video, you know how I teach. I teach by going through simple notes that I prepared so that at the end of the day, you understand any topic that has been discussed. So today our topic is sales and purchase day books. Let us go through. So that's our topic, sales and purchase day books. Learning objectives. A, distinguish between a credit sale and a cash sale. B, know what an invoice is. C, know what a sales day book is and how to record transactions in it, including the sales ledger and the sales account. D, distinguish between a credit purchase and a cash purchase. E, know what a purchase day book is and how to record transactions in it, including the purchases ledger and the purchases account. So lesson number one, what is a credit sale and a cash sale? Credit sales are goods sold and payment received later. That is, no cash is collected immediately. A receivable, that is debtor, is created. Whilst a cash sales are goods sold and cash, either money or check or in kind, is received immediately. So let me pause here and explain. When we say credit sales, it means that the goods has been sold, the money has not been received immediately. Later on, money will be received. And as such, a receivable, formerly called debtor, is what is created. The cash is, the goods are sold, the money received immediately. So that is what the difference between a cash sales and a credit sales. Let us continue. Two, what is an invoice? This is a document sent by the seller to the buyer showing proof of evidence of sales. To the seller, it is a sales invoice, and to the buyer, a purchase invoice. It shows the dates, names, and addresses of seller and buyer, invoice number, purchase order number, details of the item sold, each quantity sold, price each, total amount. So an invoice is a document showing proof of payment whenever goods are sold to a customer. Okay. And I'm saying that to the seller, it is what? It is a sales invoice, but to the purchaser, it is what? A purchase invoice. Okay. And it has details. The details are the dates. That when you take a little bit invoice, what you see on it is the date, the names and addresses of the seller and the buyer, the invoice number, the purchase order number, details of the item sold, each quantity sold, price each, and what total amount. Let us continue. Three, what is A sales day book or journal? This is a subsidiary book of account where daily sales of credit sales only, but not cash sales, are recorded. So it's a subsidiary book of an account. That the sales day book or journal is a subsidiary book of account, whereby only sales on credit are recorded in. That is what the sales day book. Okay, so that means no cash sales is recorded in the sales day book. The reason for the sales day book is that normally, whenever goods are purchased, the person receiving the goods, that the debtor will be debited, and the corresponding entry will be in the what in the sales account. But we don't want, because the goods are so daily, we don't want to take every single sale to the sales account. So we do sales table so that all the sales will be recorded in it. And at the end of the day, the total sales will be taken to the sales account. While the individual sales, those who are receiving the money, they will be sent to what? They will be sent individually to the sales ledger. So in order to prevent the sales account, that is the sales account in the general ledger, but was being overwhelmed with so many entries, that's why what we prepare what sales table. Let us go. Okay. B, sales ledger. These are personal ledgers to record individual receivable debtors. That is, when they receive the goods, then what we record them because they are paying on credit. They don't pay cash outright, so it's a credit sale. Then we have to make sure that all the individual accounts have been debited with the goods purchase. Okay. So and it can be found what the sales ledger. All the ledgers that are at the sales ledger, or you ensure that all of them, if it's 1,000 customers, that goods have been sold on credit. We take, we open a sales ledger for them and make sure that all the accounts have been debited with the individual goods purchase. Okay. C, sales account. This is the account to record the total sales, that is both cash and credit sales. This account is found in the general ledger. So the concern after crediting the individual sales in the sales ledger, then the corresponding entry will go toward the sales account. And the sales account can be found in the general ledger. Okay, let us continue. Now for sales table procedure. So that's how we record the sales table. The procedure what? A, take the invoice or invoices, scrutinize it with purchase order to ensure that everything is accurate. So before you record anything they say, we take the invoice and go through all the sales that has been done before with the purchase order, because the customer will place an order through the purchase order, then the goods will be sold to the customer. So you take the purchase order, compare it individually with the invoice to make sure that every item that has been received is what is correct. So with the purchase ledger and the purchase order will ensure that all the invoices are accurate. When you realize that you take the purchase order and the invoices and realize there are differences, then the goods has to be the seller should be notified of the inaccuracy so that it can be corrected. Okay, so after you made sure that what all the invoices correspond with the purchase order, then you go on. B, transfer the following to the sales table. So then you start recording your sales table. I, the dates. I, individual receivable names or name. I, invoice number or numbers. IB, each sale transaction. V, total sum or amount involved. Okay, C, transfer individual receivable, that is receivable or receivables account to the sales ledger. That is what they are what you open the sales ledger, make sure each person that has received will be debited with all the amount. Okay. Then D, take the total sum to the sales account in the general ledger. So the day booked, all the total sales will go. Will go to the sales account in the general ledger, whereby it will be credited. And all individual sales in the sales table will go to the sales ledger in the account. Okay. So you look at an example of what an invoice. So A, how to prepare an invoice. Example one, on 21st, I've shaded it yellow in order to indicate the items necessary to be taken to the what, to be recorded in the, to be taken or to be recorded in the what, the invoice, the invoice, on the invoice. Okay. On 21st April 2016, Mr. Williams of business address number 23, Manport Street, sold goods on credit to Desmond Limited of business address number 32, Duke Street. For this purchase order of DMT 2067, the details of the sales is what were, one, two laptops at $3,500 each, four hard drives of $500 each, 10 pen drives of what, of 100 CDs each. Prepare the sales invoice number WLM2687 of Mr. William. So that's the solution. The first item that we see on the invoice was the invoice number. So this is the invoice number. That's it. Okay. Then the next item is on the purchase order number. So this is what should be taken, should be included. This is the purchase order number. Purchase order number DMD 2067. That is what is in this here. Purchase order number DMD 2067. Okay, the next one is the address of the seller, Mr. William, 26 Manport Street, and the date 21st April 2016. So when you come here, this is the address of the seller, Mr. William. Business address number 26 Manport Street, and the date is what? Or 21st April 2016. Okay, the next is what? The buyer, Desmond Limited, 32 Duke Street. So we have the buyer, Desmond Limited, 32 Duke Street. Then we go to we record the items bought. So the item, we see the item, the price per item in total. So the first one, two laptops, $3,500. And the total is what? $7,000. So this one, the first item, two laptops at $3,500. Dollars each, the first one. The second one, four hard drives of $500 each. So we come to the next item. Four hard drives, $500 each, and the total is of $2,000. The next item, 10 pen drives of 100 CDs each. That is this one. 10 pen drives of 100 CDs each, and the total is what? $1,000. Then we have the total is worth $10,000. Okay, we look at an example two. Example two, on 1st October 2016, Mr. Williams of business address 26 Manport Street, sold goods on credit to Moness Limited of business address 12 Asmont Street. For this purchase order, DMD 3067, the details of the sales is what? I, six laptops at $5,500 each. I, nine hard drives of $500 each. I, 20 pen drives of $50 each. Prepare the sales invoice number WLM3680 of Mr. Williams. So that's what. So the first item is invoice number WLM3680. So when we come here, this is the invoice number, WLM3680. The purchase order is the next item. So purchase order DMD 3067. So when we come, this is the purchase order. Purchase order, DMG 3067. Then Mr. Williams, the seller's address, 26 Manford Street. And the date, 1st October 2016. So the address, Mr. Williams, at 26 Manford Street. Date, 1st October 2016. Then the buyer, Honest Limited, address, 21 Aspont Street. So when we come here, Honest Limited address was 12 Aspont Street. Then the details of the items. So item. We have the item, the price per item, and the total. So six laptops, the first one is six laptops, $5,500. And the total is $33,000. So when we count the first item, six laptops at $5,500 each. So that's it, six laptops, $5,500 each. Okay, and the total, $33,000. The next item, nine hard drives of $500 each. So nine hard drives of $500 is making $4,500. Okay, the next item, 20 pen drives of $50 each. So 20 pen drives of $50 each, and it's worth $1,000. Then we have the total, which is $38,500. Okay. Now B, the sales table. Using the two examples above of Mr. Williams' credit sales to record the sales table. So we use the examples above to record the sales table. Okay. So the first one is what? Two laptops, $3,500 each at $7,000. So this item to be written in the sales table. 21st, April 2016, who Desmond Limited, because it was sold to Desmond Limited. The seller Desmond Limited. So we have Desmond Limited, and the what? The invoice number is WLM2687. So when we come here, this is the invoice number. Invoice number WLM2687. Then we come to what? The amount, the total amount, $10,000. So you realize that the total amount $10,000. So you realize that the items that are needed to be recorded in the sales day book are what? The items. The items bought, and what the total amount. So that is why when you come to the sales table, we don't record the individual sales, but what we record the total amount. So you realize that the sales table, all the items, those things needed to be recorded are what the date, the sales, the details of the sales, that is the person that the good has been sold, the invoice number. The folio later on, I will explain why we use the folio and the amount involved. And the amount is what? Not the individual sales, but what the total sales that will be taken to the sales table. No, but not the individual sales. We don't need the individual sales. So the next one is what? The date. First, then 2016, and the details. Honest Limited. And the invoice number is WM3680, and the total amount is $38,500. So when we come here, we have what? The date, which is 1st October 2016. We don't record this individual ones. You know, we don't need that. The total that will be recorded, $38,500. So when you come in 38,500, the invoice number is there, 3680 is there. The invoice number 3680. Then the next one is what? You have the details, that's honest method. And the date, 1st 10, 2016. So come here, you have the goods with Honest Limited. You don't, and the what? And the dates. Okay, so there, those are the only items needed to be recorded in the book. So we use the invoices to record the books. Okay. Let's continue. So this one particular one, the sales day book will show the total, which is $48,500. Okay. Now see, sales ledger, that's the personal ledgers, and sales account, that's the general ledger. So let's see how we transfer the item from the sales day book to what? To the sales ledger, and to what? To the in the personal ledgers, and also to the sales account, to the general ledger. Okay, so from the sales day book of Warner Limited, prepare the sales ledger and sales account. So this is the sales book of Warner Limited. We show this individual says 21st April 2016, that's more limited. The invoice number is what? WLM 2687, sales ledger 12, and what? The amount is about $10,000. Okay, so we have the sales day book, as I said, what will be needed is what the date, the details, the invoice number, folio number, and amount. So that's why we have the date, the first one, 21st April 2016, the date, Desmond Limited, invoice number WLM 2687, and the folio, SL12. The folio shows where it can be traced in the page in the sales ledger where this particular items will be recorded. That's the purpose of the folio. And the amount is about $10,000. The next one, 1st 10, 2016, the details is what? Honest Limited. So we have date. Next one, 1st 10, 2016, the details, Honest Limited. Invoice number, WLM 3680. Folio, there are what the sales ledger where the particular transaction can be found. Sales ledger number 20, $38,500. The next one, date, 5th 10, 2016, details, Mass Limited, invoice number WLM 3891, folio, where it can be found in the sales ledger page 25, amount $8,500. The next one, date 8/10/2016, details, Thomas Limited, invoice number WLM 3950, folio, SL30, amount $7,500. The next one is what? The next one, date 15/10/2016. This is Joints Limited, invoice number WLM 3958, folio SL, sales ledger number 35. The amount is about $6,000. Then the last item, date 17/10/2016. Details, Black Limited, invoice number WLM 4055. Folio SL49 and amount is for $9,400. The total amount 1,605,160. Okay. Now let's look how you transfer the amount to the sales ledger. So this is the sales ledger. The solution, this is the sales ledger. That the personal ledgers of the individual. So the first one is Desmond Limited. Let's see how we record it from the sales day book to the sales ledger. So the sales ledger, we have the T account showing the date. I have a video on the T format. You can click on the link below to go and watch that particular video. We have the date, the particulars, folio and amount that is on the left hand side of the T ledger or the T format. Then on the right hand side, we have date, particulars, folio, and amount. This right hand side is for the debit entry. This left hand side, sorry, this left hand side for the credit is for the debit entry. Sorry. This left hand side is for the credit entries, and the right hand side is for the debit entry. Now, this is since they are receiving the goods they bought on credit. So, the first one is what? We have the date with 20. First for 2016. First for 2016. That's one limited. He bought the items on credit. So, it's what it says. That's the particular it says. Then the folio. It can be found in sales book number 29. So, assuming this is sales day book number 29. Okay. And the amount he bought is $10,000. $10,000. So he has been debited with the amount in the sales level. So the next person is Moneys Limited. So we have the date, 1st 10, 2016 date. He has also been debited because he's receiving the good 1st 10, 2016 particulars is sales folio. So we assume that this one is sales day book number 29. And the amount is $38,500. So the amount $38,500 is on next limited. That's his item. So it will be debited. The next one is for the debit months limited. So you have the 12th and 2016, the particular sales folio, sales day book 29. The amount is for $8,500. So we come to the next one. Fifth and 2016 month limited. Then it can be found. Month limited can be found in sales ledger number 25. The amount $8,500. That's what I've just shown. So you come to monthly. You see the page that the sales ledger page 25. That is has been indicated here. Sales ledger 25 and the amount of $8,500 in the name of what man submitted, the date is 1st 10, 2016. So when you come to his account, man submitted account, he has been debited 1st 10, 2016, which is the date. So we come to the date. First and 2016 in the name of man submitted. So you come here. That is account once submitted. And this the particular date and the full where can be passed. This is let me assume that this one is since the book what? This is the book number 25. The amount involved is what? $8,500. So when you come here, I'll be debited with $8,500. The next one is Thomas submitted. So we have the date 8 and 2016. So when you come here, 8th 2016, whose account? Thomas Limited account. So when you come to account is Thomas Limited account. The page is sales ledger page 30. So when you come here, you see that it is written there at the folio column. Sales ledger. And the amount is $7,500. Amount is worth $7,500. Then the next one is Jones Limited. So we have the date 15, 10, 2016. So 15, 10, 2016, Jones Limited. So Jones Limited. So folio, that's where particularly sees folios. We assume that this is this book is what page 29. And the amount you probably is $6,000. So when you come here, it's $6,000. So the sales ledger where it can be found is sales ledger number page number 35, and it is here. 35. So the next one and the last one, Black Limited. So the date is 17, 10, 2016. So 17, 10, 2016, Black Limited. Black Limited, particularly sales folio, sales debut 29, and amount $9,400 debited. So it come here. $9,400 debited. And it can be found on sales ledger page 49. So when you come here, it says ledger page 40. So you realize that all the individual, who have been sold or those goods, all of them, the accounts have been debited because what they are receiving the goods. So that's why we open the sales ledger and debit all of them. All of them have been debited. All of them have been debited in the sales ledger account. All of them. Okay. Now, the total summation, which is 1,605,160 dollars. This total sum has been transferred. So we see that the date is 30th, 2016. Detail transferred to general ledger. And the general ledger, the folio is the page number. General ledger page 80. The amount of $1,605,160. It has been transferred to the general ledger, page 80, to the sales account, and it has been credited. Why? Because what it is, that is giving out the goods to the individual. So you have to be credited. Once we have debited the individual account, the corresponding entry should be what? Should go to the credit side of the sales account. So what the sales account has been credited. So you have date 30th, the last 30th, 2016 particular is called credit sales, as I said. And the folio sales day book, as soon as sales day book number 29, and the total amount involved, $1,605,160, all have been transferred. So that's the purpose of the sales ledger. Instead of crediting the sales account in the general ledger with the individual sales set of credit, we rather record all in the sales ledger. Send it to the individual debit or the individual's account in the sales ledger, personal ledgers. The sales ledger, that is the personal ledger. Then we take the total sum to what? To the general ledger, the sales account in the general ledger. We take the total sum there so that the general ledger will not be what? Overwhelmed with so many entries. We just take the total sum there. So that's the purpose of what? Or the usage of the sales table. We prevent so many entries being entered into the sales account. So we have come to the end of the video. We will continue. Accounting is just a procedure. You take your time, you don't combine so many, so otherwise it will confuse your student. So we will end here. Next time we continue from there. Please, accounting is a principle, as always said. Go over this video several times so that you understand it and it becomes familiar to you. Practice make man perfect. So don't think that you've watched the first video, you're okay. You are never okay. Go over several times, record it and go over several times. And also, I want you to do this for me. Like, and also share it to your friends and tell them about this particular channel, the Accounting for Beginners. The purpose of me creating the Accounting for Beginners is to simplify accounting, because most people find accounting very difficult and complex, but it's easy. That's why I take my time and go through step by step and teach you so that you understand it. To tell others about it, share it and like it. This will rather encourage me. And secondly, I want you to also comment so that I can improve on my performance and give you better videos. It's for your own good. And also, that but not the least, I want you to also watch subscribe. When you subscribe, every week I do two or three videos so that it can be sent to you. And as I said, I'm a chartered accountant. So if you are a business owner, you need somebody to keep your books or do other accounting services for you. Both my email address and my telephone number to the WhatsApp number. I delete below. Go to the show more session and you can get in contact with me. Also, if you want to learn accounting, you can also contact me. Whether you are accountant, you can also contact me. And also, if you're a student, you are struggling with accounting, you're going to write the exams, you don't pass, or you get low grades, you can also contact me and I'm available to teach you. So we have come to the end of the day. Thank you very much for watching and watch us for my next video. Bye.